Hi friends, today we will have a brief review on encephalitis. It's an inflammation of the brain tissue. The most common cause is viral infections. In rare cases, it can be caused by bacteria or even fungi. There are two main types of encephalitis, primary and secondary. Primary encephalitis, it occurs when a virus infects directly to the brain and the spinal cord. Secondary encephalitis, it occurs when an infection starts in the body elsewhere and it moves to the brain. The encephalitis is rare yet serious disease that can be fatal. The immediate diagnosis and treatment is necessary. Next, we will see the symptoms of encephalitis. The symptoms of encephalitis can range from mild to severe. The mild symptoms include fever, headache, vomiting, lethargy, and stiff neck. The severe symptoms include high-grade fever, confusion, hallucination, drowsiness, slower movements, coma, seizure, irritability, sensitivity to light, and unconsciousness. The infants and young children show different symptoms like vomiting, body stiffness, bulging fontanel lace, and constant crying, poor appetite. Next, we will discuss about the causes of encephalitis. Many different viruses can cause encephalitis. They are categorized into three groups: common viruses, childhood viruses, and arboviruses. First, we will see about the common viruses. The most common virus that can cause encephalitis is herpes simplex virus. The others include mumps, HIV, and cytomegaloviruses. This form of encephalitis is affecting mostly the frontal lobe and the temporal lobe. The encephalitis is caused by the herpes simplex virus is mostly dangerous. It can cause severe damage to the brain and even death. Next is childhood viruses. Examples: measles, rubella, chickenpox. Vaccines can prevent these viruses that cause encephalitis. That's why nowadays these type of encephalitis are very rare. The third one is arbovirus. These are the viruses carried by insects. For example, Nipah virus, West Nile viruses. Next, what are the risk factors for encephalitis? The groups most at risk are older adults, infants, people with immune deficiency, people who are living in an area where mosquitoes and ticks are common, because mosquitoes and ticks can carry viruses that can cause encephalitis. Then the diagnosis. It can be done by proper history taking, CT or MRI scan, lumbar puncture, EEG to determine where the area of brain affected, and the blood test. And what about the treatment? Of course, there will be antiviral medications and symptomatic management with proper rest, painkillers, corticosteroids to reduce brain inflammation, mechanical ventilation for assist breathing, anticonvulsants, and sedatives, and IV fluids. Now we'll look to the complications associated with encephalitis. The complications include loss of memory, behavioral changes, epilepsy, speech defect, physical disability, intellectual problems, lack of muscle coordination, hearing problem, vision loss, coma, and even death. Then the prognosis. The prognosis of the encephalitis depends on the severity of the brain inflammation. In mild cases, the inflammation of the brain likely resolve in few days. In severe cases, it might take weeks or months to get better. People with encephalitis may also experience paralysis, loss of brain function, problem with the speech, behavior, memory, and balance. So depending on the problem that they have, it may be necessary to get additional therapies like physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy, and psychotherapy. Finally, the prevention. The encephalitis is not always preventable, but we can lower the risk by proper vaccination and avoid mosquitoes and tick bites. Thanks for watching. See you with the next class. Bye-bye.